the sound of your heartbeat. Your pulse is pushing against me. I'm good when you are around.
Morning, guys. Welcome to day 3 or episode 3 or however it is I'm going to brand this. Today, we were really hoping, like we went to bed hoping we'd go to the Isle of Skye today. It's 3 hours away from here, and we were going to go there, we were going to get some fantastic footage, and it's also one of the locations that you can see the aurora borealis. The only thing is, we woke up this morning, it's blustering like crazy, the lochs are choppy, and yeah, the weather report and everything like that, it just doesn't seem like a good day to go and do that sort of thing, especially when really you need a clear night. And it's not a guarantee that we'll see it, so we want to sort of make sure that we've got everything in our favour. But we'll see, it'd be interesting if we get it anyway, it would be amazing. But today we decided to reiterate our plans.
Did you hear that?
That was amazing! Get some more stones! That was...
What? People say, choop, 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 choop!
So we just stopped off on the road towards Loch Leven, because I want to try and get a shot of this bridge and the mountain range behind it, because it looks spectacular. But the shot doesn't seem as easy as you think, but we should be able to get it. Oh, it's blustering.
You keep me warm in your bloodstream, you keep me calm when you're breathing. Now I don't know what I've done.
To look out over Loch Leven, and it's a great view, perfect place to get the drone out, but it is rather windy, and even the loch itself is considerably choppy. I mean, let's get the window down for you. It's great to get the drone out, but it's not worth the risk, is it? So instead, we're just getting a load of photos. Right, guys, so where we were going to go, we can't actually go because, well, it's closed off. There's a gateway on the road that takes you over towards the other locks on the other side, where I plan to go today. So obviously, you can't get through the gate, it's all chained up and everything. So what we're doing now is I'm driving all the way back down the same road again, and I think we'll head into Fort William and out past that way, and maybe even go to Glenfinnan, which is where we went to last time, and it is also the same location. Like Glenfinnan, it has got a viaduct, which is the train bridge that they used in the Harry Potter films. That is where we're going now. I've also had a bit of problems with my phone again, keeps dying on me. When I'm trying to film outside, because it is way too cold. It's not as cold as it was yesterday, I don't feel, but the phone clearly thinks it is. Making up as it goes on, really, because we can't go where we wanted to. But at least we've got some good footage on the road on the way here, so I guess that's the main thing. It's not a wasted sort of journey, as it were.
What is eternal about love? If there's a way to turn it off, you know, so show me the way. But if try enough, you will not
arrived at Glenfinnan, which is where the Harry Potter Viaduct is. I did actually have a look to see how much it was to go on the train from Fort William to Mallaig, I think it is. It's like £575. On a train. So we'll get some footage of this, and then over there we might get some footage of the monument as well. And there, get some footage of the loch and the surrounding mountains around it. And it's a bit chillier here. The wind, I hope I don't regret saying this, but the wind is quite, well, non-existent. So the drone might get some nice stuff. But fantastic view that way. But the depth of the different mountains going on. Let's get the drone out and get some footage. Such a picturesque view, it's spectacular. Quinn's down there getting some footage now, and I think I just blinded myself by looking down at him. Oh, that sun is so bright. I think the footage I got looks quite nice, and I won't even know until I get back now. Because you think it looks good on your phone, until you get back and put it on a bigger screen, you're like, oh, that doesn't look right. So that's tough, but I've changed the exposure. I've tried different settings. It's just, I want to fly out that way. But the sun is creating such an overexposure that it's underexposed in the dark areas in the lens, so it's not capturing how good this actually really looks. I managed to get a nice low shot flying out going up. Hopefully it does look good. If not, I could rectify it in post. But yeah, it's, so you have a vision of what it is you want to shoot and what it is you want to get, but the elements and real life gets in the way. But it's a nice location here. Now I think we've got more than our fair share of footage today, but what we're going to do now is we're going to chase the sun. The sun's practically set now. When I said we were going to chase the sun, we then got distracted and filmed some more because we found like a little snowy area and there was a bridge and you could get higher up and look at the same view and it just looks great. And then we thought we've left it too late to even go anywhere, so we decided to stay here. It was very cloudy, so it's not as great of a sunset as we wanted. And I think tomorrow, in fact, we're actually going to head sort of over that side of this loch and see what's over there, and potentially take a car ferry. We need to double check how much it is, because if it's £178, I'll rather swim. Anyway, we're going to get back in the car now and we're going to head back to the place and potentially get some fish and chips. Yeah.